the Bone Rocker Show at Revolution Radio, freedomslips.com.
Let me just read down these list of parties here. We're on the header of my recent court document. And it says United States, that's lowercase, v. U.S. Inc. and United States of America. R.E., okay, and all the rest of these entities. Okay, and that's basically regarding or the res. Okay, we got the Food and Drug Administration, Freesburg Ethics Commission, that's Fiji, House of Representatives, United States Senate, Office of Population Affairs, as the U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, Dr. Henry Kissinger, Broadcasting Board of Governors, Federal Deposit Insurance Corporation, U.S. Department of Education, Department of Transportation, State of Indiana, St. Joseph County, St. Joseph Regional Medical Center, Trinity Health International. That's all directly related to my mom's recent demise. Andrew P. Stewart.
Stewart.
Seawort, we'll call him.
Seawort.
Yeah.
SpongeBob Seawort.
Corporate Council, Association of Corporate Council, St. Joseph County Board of Commissioners, Michael P. Scopolitis, David C. Chaplow, the bank, Judith L. Fox, Assessor of Real Property. She's a professor of law over at Notre Dame University. Philip P. Simon, the bank. Michael Bernicke, real property broker. Michael Chabot, real property broker. United States Postal Service. The National Science Foundation. U.S. Government Printing Office. Department of Energy. NIPSCO, and all other public utilities, also known as Sestake Vi Trust, stemming from Massachusetts Land Trust through action of embezzlement.
Say what? Sestake Vi Act Trust? What?
Yeah, we can revisit that here. Let me get to the meat of this here. Clerk of St. Joseph County Superior Court, Terry Rethlake. Clerk of United States District Court, Robert Dragovich. Department of Commerce, Patent and Trademark. WIPO, that's World Intellectual Property Association. It has to do with patents and things. CIA, Central Intelligence Agency. John Brennan, Director. International Psychoanalytical Association. International Corrections and Prisons Association. And with that, back after this short, I should try to plow through this five-page order that I wrote. These matters, having come before the United States Court, that's lowercase, on October 28, 2013, by joinder of parties, united, containing identical and concurrent jurisdictions stemming from criminal acts. Now, October 28th was the day that they admitted my mother into the hospital. That's the reasoning behind that date. This court is understood as evidence and acknowledged by the U.S. Department of State, John Forbes Kerry, Vice President of the United States Incorporated, Joseph Biden, President of the Senate, United States of America, Senate and House of Representatives, Ed Perlmutter, House of Representatives, Central Intelligence Agency, Jim Hines, House of Representatives, John Boehner, House of Representatives, and Jay Rockefeller, Senate Department of Commerce, on behalf of the aforementioned defendants, wherein, upon evidence of low-intensity conflict, operations, co-conspirators via psychological warfare known as Hearts and Minds, by which the United States Incorporated is actively engaging in and promoting genocide through the Food and Drug Administration, also known as the FDA, maintaining contracts with the Freedberg Ethics Commission International, Fiji, by and through congressional action of the U.S. Senate and House of Representatives, 16 U.S.C. Chapter 7, and the Office of Population Affairs, otherwise known as the Department of Health and Human Services, established in 1975 by Dr. Henry Kissinger as a depopulation pogrom Memorandum 200, National Security Council, enabled through Act of Congress of the U.S. Senate and the House of Representatives, entitled the 1947 National Security Act, 50 U.S.C. Chapter 15, further evidencing the use of hearts and minds as fourth-generation warfare via the color of an illusion of decentralization, implication of long-term terrorism, the use of cultures, religious indoctrination, media manipulation through the Broadcasting Board of Governors, maintaining international control of all civil media, lawfare, psychological warfare via political, economic, social, and military pressure upon humankind. This schematic generating revenues in the criminal action of embezzlement, treasury, through legal mechanisms to impart upon the human mind concepts wherein these vessels are constantly and consequently being altered of their heading for 46 U.S.C. Chapter 311 and 313 via advertising of monumental sort and consortium, the back end insurance with again ill-gotten revenues from this criminal enterprise known as Confederacy. Then we define Confederacy from Black's first edition, which we have covered several times. In criminal law, the association or banding together of two or more persons for the purpose of committing an act or furthering an enterprise which is forbidden by law, or by which the lawful in itself becomes unlawful when made the object of the Confederacy. Conspiracy is a more technical term for this offense. It also means the act of two or more who combine together to do any damage or injury to another or to do any unlawful act. Now, stemming from three variations of law, one, meta, which is morality, two, soma, which is psychology, and three, veda, which is ethics. Now, we've referred to that in the past as the new law, but veda directly means ethics. The human being special deposit has been converted into another resource, and therein altered of condition through action of shipping, bottomry, diagnosis, and repair, otherwise known as commerce and navigation, mechanized by patent and trademark through venues such as WIPO, that's the World Intellectual Property Organization, whereby these vessels are reported injured via intelligence provided to the House of Lords through address of clergy. Now, that's when the president makes a State of the Union address, he's addressing the House of Lords, by which to appropriate monies from the Treasury upon fraudulent claim as injury is maintained by congressional direction and action upon humankind within aforementioned criminal enterprise that we define Confederacy under. Victims henceforth forced through compulsion and maintained as concepts, otherwise known as conceit, or the action of moving, navigating, conveying, giving, granting, assigning, holding, keeping, maintaining, and transporting vessels, alteration of heading through action of psychiatry via psychological artificial intelligence, designed, created by the production company called the CIA, and broadcast globally through the Broadcasting Board of Governors as maintained by the Council on Foreign Relations, including but not limited to the productions espoused to the House of Lords by which to fraudulently embezzle monies out of the Treasury for the sole purpose of promoting, acting upon, and engaging in genocide against the human race, whereby through the codification maintained as international statistical classification of diseases and related health problems, currently ICD-10, these vessels are then being repaired due to the injury imposed upon them by aforementioned Confederacy in action. And we mentioned specifically the 113th Congress assembled, today's Congress. Marine insurance, original charters, borne by the underwriters subscribing to the psychological construct, color illusion, guise of known as Law the Emergency Management, FEMA, 6 U.S.C. Chapter 1, Subchapter 5, Subsection 313, through patent, trademark, and intellectual property, otherwise known as concepts, otherwise known as conceit, or the action of moving, navigating, and transporting vessels, alteration of heading through action of psychiatry via psychological design. United States of America, by Act of Congress, the United States Incorporated, and criminal enterprise known as Confederacy, League, Association of Nations, International, United Nations, and other known conspirators, having knowledge and a forethought, continues with intent to perpetrate genocide of the human race as psychopaths, bankrupt, depraved, and without honor, divesting liberty, a franchise only granted within honors. Whereby the United States of America, by action of Congress, United States Incorporated, and criminal enterprise known as Confederacy, Association of Nations International, United Nations, and other conspirators, with knowledge and a forethought, and acting with intent to perpetuate genocide of the human race, has forfeited the treasury to the United States, that's lowercase, of being, I am, the human race. These monies shall be deposited into the United States Bank, that's lowercase, incorporated by original charter and declaration of trust, record number 123-9990, located at St. Joseph County, Indiana, docket entry 1, that goes back to our original docket entry into USDC, the United States, lowercase, Bank, having succeeded all others on January 25th, 2013, that was the entry date of that initial USDC entry, without argument, counterclaim, or otherwise of any authority, representative, agent, or other on behalf of defendants, listed, or co-conspirators. Again, docket entry 1. The United States of America, as actions of Congress, United States Incorporated, and criminal enterprise known as Confederacy, League, Associations of Nations, International, United Nations, and other known conspirators, are without immunity or sovereignty. As per 28 U.S.C. Chapter 97, the Foreign Sovereignties Immunities Act, and the restricted principle of sovereign immunity, and shall not be protected upon penalty of death, aiding and abetting the enemy of humankind. All human children shall be immediately returned to their houses. Human being shall be determined by virtue of being. Psychopathy shall not be protected. Psychopathy is a predator of humankind. Psychopathy shall be capitalized by its chosen form of government as per the Atlantic Charter, 1941. United States, lowercase, of being, otherwise known as humanity, shall nevermore be capitalized. Any lost, orphaned, or otherwise child in need shall be protected by the Treasury and removed from congressional grasp, holding, institution, prison, hospital, warehouse, and or deposit corporation immediately, to be held, kept, and protected by the United States, lowercase. Remember, we're the ones protecting humanity. Attempting first to return said children to their places, houses of origin. There shall be in place a permanent injunction and restraint upon all criminal actors wherein all known psychopaths shall remain 100 miles away from human life. Penalty of death for violation. North Korea, also known as a project and design, Pyongyang, of congressional action and intelligence, shall house, keep, hold, and maintain psychopaths, observing birth control and sterilization procedures already conceptualized, agreed upon, and consented to by criminal enterprise. If one psychopath should kill another psychopath, this shall be considered abortion, as conceptualized, agreed upon, and consented to by aforementioned psychopaths, as psychopathy is without sentience or ability to exist separate from a host body, politic, or franchise state, as evidenced by its works in action. Psychopathy is not to be confused with life or be living, and shall be directed by current policy, sign, die, detriment upon market conditions, of aforementioned civilly dead surety, natural persons, uses, usufruct, taxes, terms, fees, charges, black, white acres, stock options, commercial units, consumptive goods, as well as any other entitlement by which they subscribe as defined under laws of instance, mortgage, copyhold, commerce, and navigation, as per law and custom. The capacity of the usufruct shall not be diminished. Psychopaths shall be administered by the FDA Ethics Commission and recommendations of the revised World Medical Association's Declaration of Helsinki, the directives and guidelines of the European Union and the regulations of the United States Food and Drug Administration, FDA, as maintained by Rules of Procedure, 2006, current edition. These resources, also known as test subjects, shall uphold the current trade agreements of Korea and the United States Incorporated, with all remaining revenue minus 90%, to be used for the care and maintenance of aforementioned psychopaths as originally conceptualized by Article 12 of the Articles of Confederation, without change. Institutions formerly known as any warehouse facility under the control or discretion of the Department of Education shall be obliterated, dissolved, and replaced with deprogramming facilities for the express benefit of humankind. Psychopaths shall be charged as fees to cover this and related expenditures via the Bretton Woods Agreement, the structure of the International Monetary Fund. Now, yeah, if you know what the Bretton Woods agreements were really about, you know, it was an extension of the, again, human beings being held as surety. Deprogramming facilities shall not use the Delphi technique, Alinsky methods, consensus creation, or any other psychological warfare upon humankind. Deprogramming, as evidenced by the United States of being in action, evidences that this shall take no more than 2 years to complete and shall include metaphysics via metaphor, knowledge of the self, as a supportive structure disallowing cognitive dissonance. Code is maintained through the IMF as to special drawing rights shall allow for the whole without compartmentalization, regard to age, a legal construct, or any other concept by which to move human being away from or otherwise outside the self. Exodus. Whereas this confederacy in action is applied fourth generation warfare upon humankind by which to force unsuspecting subscribers, underwriters to be the guarantee insurance in a perpetual game of confidence. Reference 27 CFR 72.11. Commercial crimes. Since the original charters, okay, and the original charters are Act of Surrender and Great Charter of New England to His Majesty, June 7, 1635. Articles of Confederation of the United Colonies under New England, May 19, 1643. Charter for the Province of Pennsylvania, February 28, 1681. Charter of Arcadia, granted by Henry 4, I guess, of France to Peru de Gaste, Sieur de Monts, December 18, 1603. Charter of Carolina, March 24, 1663. Charter of Carolina, June 30, 1665. Charter of Connecticut, April 23, 1662. Charter of Maryland, June 20, 1632. Charter of Massachusetts Bay, March 4, 1629. Charter of Massachusetts Bay, October 7, 1691. Charter of New England, November 3, 1620, Charter of Privileges with Gustavus Adolphus Haas, graciously given by letters patent to the newly established Swedish South Company, June 14, 1626. Charter of Rhode Island and Providence Plantations, July 15, 1663. Charter of the Colony of New Plymouth, granted to William Bradford and his associates, 1629. Charter of the Dutch West India Company, June 3, 1621. Charter of Fundamental Laws of West New Jersey, agreed upon 1676. First Charter of Virginia, April 10, 1606. General Charter for those who discover any new passages, Havens, Countries, or Places, March 27, 1614. Penn's Charter of Liberty, April 25, 1682. Petition for a Charter of New England by the Northern Company of Adventures, March 3, 1619-1620. The Second Charter of Virginia, May 23, 1609. The Third Charter of Virginia, March 12, 1611. Charter of Liberties, Coronation Charter, 1100. The Gelnhausen Charter, 1180. Confirmation of Charters, 1297. Charter to Sir Walter Raleigh, 1584. Letters Patent to Sir Humphrey Gilbert, 1588. The Dialogue Concerning the Exchequer, 1180. And all and every of them a production and discourse altering the heading of these vessels, the United States of Being in Rem et al. Libertas, I am. Wherein these playwrights, scribes, have continually maintained under house known as marquee, defined as 1. A large tent, often with open sides, used chiefly for outdoor entertainment. 2. A roof-like structure, often bearing a signboard, projecting over an entrance, as to the theater or hotel, also called marquees, providing that with transgression, literally translated as Congress, under style, chain of events, congressional action, humanity, through trick and deception, has been subject of a grand illusion, colored guise of psychological construct known as law, language, culture, religious indoctrination, and various concepts, by which to be altered of their original heading, being as evidenced by counsel of Confederacy in Action, November 21st, 2012, and henceforth, wherein Andrew P. Seward, Corporate Counsel, Association of Corporate Counsel, acknowledges and further maintains in deed and silence, whilst implicating fourth-generation warfare, evidenced by his works and actions and that of his co-conspirators, including, but not limited to, David Chaplow, Nipsco, and any and all of them participating as evidenced by their own works. In a briefing paper to the Department of State written in 1996 as the first working paper, GSO1, of the Yale program in genocide studies, Gregory H. Stanton defines genocide as, in the present convention, genocide means any of the following acts committed with intent to destroy in whole or in part a national, ethical, racial, or religious group, such as A. killing members of the group. B. causing serious bodily or mental harm to members of the group. C. deliberately inflicting on the group conditions of life calculated to bring about its physical destruction in whole or in part. D. imposing measures intended to prevent births within the group. E. forcibly transferring children of the group to another group. Wherefore, defendants known by their works and action and upon contract the fee schedule shall be measured by their works in action as per fee schedule record number 1237493 located in St. Joseph County, Indiana. USD 313 CV052 docket entry 1. And that's it.
And that's it.
There's a lot in there. I know. It's a lot to take in. It was a lot of research to even come to grips with some of the stuff. The stuff is sickening.